Every day we are surrounded by our electromagnetic radiation. Within the spectrum, there are both visible and invisible ranges of light that have been found to be effective in inactivating different microorganisms, viruses, and other pathogens. Lighting can help prevent, contain, and remove those pathogens in the space. In 1903, Niels Silsson won the Nobel Prize for the use of UV light to treat tuberculosis. Since then, UV lights have been found to have many additional applications across several industries, including disinfection. Ultraviolet light is in the non-visible portion of the spectrum, and there are a few different categories of UV light, the main ones being UVA, UVB, and UVC. In addition to the UV portion of the spectrum, studies have shown that there is also some portion of the visible lighting spectrum around 405 nanometers that have been shown to be effective against some bacteria, fungi, and some viruses that are more light sensitive. Disinfectant lighting has enough energy to break or modify the chemical bonds, mostly the DNA, but some RNA, of the cells. The process essentially disables their ability to reproduce and infect. It should be noted that not all microorganisms react the same to the same level of treatment. So while disinfectant lighting can be effective, the overall dosages and durations may vary depending on what you're trying to eliminate. There are several different form factors that disinfectant lighting comes in. Here are a couple examples of where and how the UV light can be used. First, let's look at the HVAC systems. Treating the air surfaces on HVAC equipment through the use of UV lighting, the air and surfaces can be treated to both disinfect as well as to optimize the system by preventing growth in the coils, for example. The systems are turned off while the units are being serviced so as to maintain personnel safety. Mobile units are a second option. These units are mainly used in the healthcare industry and are rolled into space to quickly disinfect surfaces while the room is unoccupied. Furthermore, we have fixed units. Fixed units come in several different form factors, and they can be used in both surface and air disinfection. For air disinfection, the units circulate the air through an air chamber in the light fixture. The air chamber contains the UV light to effectively separate the UVC light from humans. For applications where direct sources of UV light are used, care must be taken to only use when humans are not present. Studies have also shown that UVC lights can also degrade different materials such as plastics. Lastly, in addition to UVC, I mentioned that there were other forms of disinfectant lighting, all of which have their own pros and cons, but should be considered as they may be a good choice for different applications. Two I would like to mention. First, HINES, or high intensity narrow spectrum lighting. It's outside the UV range, and it has been shown to be effective against a smaller but ever-growing list of microorganisms. And it has also been shown to be safe to be used in occupied areas and does not have the negative side effects on plastics and residents that UV lighting can have. The second is far UVC. The far UVC has been shown to be an effective disinfectant tool. While initial studies have shown that far UVC will still have a negative impact on some materials, it does not appear to have the negative side effects on humans. Keep an eye out for more on this technology. Johnson Controls has been deploying both air and surface UV disinfection systems in our York units for many years. The solutions can provide both air and surface disinfection. In addition, Johnson Controls has many intelligent lighting experts across the country that work with our clients and our ecosystem partners to find and implement the best possible intelligent lighting solutions for our customers that include disinfectant lighting options. Contact your building expert at Johnson Controls. We have the technology to help you. We understand and can guide you through the stimulus and other procurement approaches. We are part of your community, and we're proud to help power your mission.